Lesson. Everywhere I go, haters wanna test me. I'm on a new game, ship, don't wanna X me. So when I blow like a king, you just bless them. Cause I do this, like the new hits. I've got the still a man, them say, ooh, this. Ain't no crucifix, I got Jesus. He's on my checklist, I'm used to this. Yo, let me tell you how I roll, homie. Been through the fire, so I'm coming up as gold, homie. Never be stressing when I got the Holy Ghost on me. I've got the greatest, the most hits, got the zone for me. So I'm in a fear, man.
Welcome back here on Dawn at NBC. It's really been a pleasure engaging with you since this show started. As I mentioned earlier before we went on break, that we have a special guest with us, Hefby. He's an artist. He's a gospel singer. His own kind of music is a very unique and, is a kind of music that I believe everybody will be exciting to be a part of. So here, Hefby, can you tell us more about what you do?
It's a pleasure being here. Thank you guys. Appreciate it. Hefby is a totally different kind of person when it comes to music. I grew up into music. Uh-huh. I started playing music at the age of really 5 years old.
Wow.
Played drums and, beautiful. Started writing my own piece of music at maybe getting close to my teenage, I was 11. Mm-hmm. And stuff, but music has been my passion. One thing about me, I realized is that I just want, I want my message to get across far and beyond, not just limited to a certain group of people.
Mm-hmm.
Even though I'm well known as a gospel artist, I believe gospel is not just to certain people, it's for everybody.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the reason why I just have, my style of music, not just to certain people, but it's diverse,
mm-hmm.
Whereby I'm able to reach out non-Christians and both Christians as
wonderful.
Well. Yeah.
Wonderful.
So what inspired you to go into, you said you sing and
yes.
you rap, so what inspired you to do that?
Being the fact that music is part of my life and stuff,
mm-hmm.
and I grew up, listening to hip-hop and stuff like
okay.
that, when I was in high school, messed around with doing circular rap music,
okay.
and, we used to battle rap back in the days in high school, and we used to, just trying to be all gangster, But at the end of the day, I just feel, I just want to be different.
Uh-huh.
Everybody does the same, but I just feel I could be different from the norm,
yes.
And people sometimes try to make it sense like, oh, you're different, you're the nerd, or I want to be different.
Yes.
So going into gospel hip hop is something mm-hmm. I feel, I want to be I want to be impactful. I want to place impact in people's
yes.
life.
Are you strictly gospel? Because I know some people dabble in both. So are you strictly just gospel and preaching a message?
Yes, I would say my line is straight positive. I would say gospel.
Okay.
But then again, it's more of an inspirational music.
Mm-hmm.
It's
right.
more of a positive music
mm-hmm.
whereby, anyone can listen to my music.
Okay.
I talk about life situation. I talk
uh-huh.
about what I go through.
Okay.
I talk about what people go through.
Wow.
I talk about general stuff that we pass through. It's more of like an encouraging thing.
Mm-hmm.
Like my newest video that is up right now is called No Stress. And the whole concept of that song is what we go through as human,
mm-hmm.
and we'll find ourselves in a situation whereby we're stressing over bills,
yes.
we're stressing over mortgage,
yes.
we're stressing over,
preach.
A whole bunch of stuff. So why are you stressing?
Okay.
That's just how it is, yeah.
And you said one thing that I really want to focus on. You said you have a message.
Right.
I'm curious to know what that message is. Really, really curious.
Well, I would say the message is more of a life-changing message.
Okay. Life, okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Life-changing because we find ourselves in situations whereby
mm-hmm.
we cannot handle it.
Yes.
But at that point, what do you do?
That's
if you
true.
Can handle that situation.
Okay.
So at that point, that's when you have to realize, there's a God somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
That's the time, I want to go on my knees and pray and say,
mm-hmm.
God, I need you at this point.
Mm-hmm.
What am I supposed to do?
Mm-hmm.
And that's just, that's that message.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I'm also wondering, as I hear you talk, like, because I know that there are many of our Nigerian community that is truly gifted in some kind of way. Yeah. Do you welcome, like, I know you say you write music.
Right.
Do you welcome, like, if somebody wants, have some a message that they want you to incorporate in your music,
oh, yeah,
do you welcome that?
Absolutely, yes, I do. You know, I'm very open to working with people. You know, I'm currently working with a couple of, I worked with an artist back in Nigeria as well, too, on one of my new singles called Elevates. It's all over.
Okay.
You can get in any music site.
Okay.
You know, featured them. Shout out to Morientes. Mm-hmm. You know, yeah. So I'm also, you know, networking with a couple of guys in Nigeria and here as well, and also in Jamaica as well, too, because,
wonderful.
You know, I have.
You
know,
do reggae.
I do reggae dance hall with a little influence to mine. So it's sort of different. So you would never hear, or as, like, most of the time, it's either you hear straight hip hop.
Okay.
Or you hear straight Afro hip hop, or you hear straight reggae dancehall.
Okay.
But with a combination of both hip hop, Afro hip hop, and dancehall all together in one song, it's rare. And
that's what makes you different.
That's what makes me different.
Okay. Wonderful.
Right.
Wonderful.
So if somebody wants to get your album or your single, is there a downloadable link?
Yeah, absolutely.
Or anything
like I'm on iTunes. You know,
iTunes.
I'm on iTunes. You know, any music site, you can Google me up.
Mm-hmm.
I tell people, like,
YouTube.
The YouTube, you know, just search for my name, HEPH space B F B. You know, and that's just how it works. And I'm here, you know, just making it happen and making it work.
And does HEPB stand for something?
Yes. Now, the full name of HEPB, when I initially got that name, is Hephzibah.
Okay.
And Hephzibah was derived from Isaiah 62, verse 4.
Ooh.
And that word Hephzibah means God's delight.
Okay.
So
wow,
it's like,
beautiful.
You know,
never knew that.
Yeah, I know. So it means God's delight, and the B part means Beulah. So as God's delight and married to God. So yeah, so it's a combination of both name,
mm-hmm.
you know. So I just took, I shortened the name.
Yes.
I gave, like, you know, so half B, you know, the full name is Hephzibah Beulah, but you know, just cut it short to stand out more.
Okay,
yeah.
Thank you so much, Hephzibah.
It's
here.
A pleasure.
It's really been a pleasure listening to you tell us about what you do, and so our viewers out there, you know, you can get his music on YouTube.
Yes.
You can also get it on iTunes,
yeah.
And you know, Google him if you want to know more about him.
Right.
So we're going to be taking a short break, and when we come back, we have something special from the Life Coach segment to share with you. Stay tuned.
So when you see me, you know I'm on the next thing. Yeah, I am blessed. And I am blessed. Say I am blessed. Yeah, make us up.
I am less. No stressing. No.